Over the past couple of years, independent wrestling fans have witnessed the meteoric rise of a very nice, very evil wrestler. Danhausen has caught the attention of fans with his bizarre yet captivating presentation, building an audience that has led him to being featured on national television. On January 27th, 2022, he would make his All Elite Wrestling debut to the shock of not only Adam Cole, but to the viewers at home. Whilst he has an avid fanbase that follow his every move, his rise to now national fame has left many with more questions than answers. So who is he and what is he all about? Well, in today's video, we attempt to answer some of those questions as we take a look at 10 things you didn't know about Danhausen, unless you're a fanhausen. And before we get into it, make sure you subscribe with notifications turned on so you don't miss the latest wrestling news, and check out the relaunched WrestlePlanet.net for daily wrestling articles. Before pursuing a career in wrestling, Donovan Danhausen had a variety of hobbies and jobs. In high school, his interest had shifted to music, becoming a drummer for both his high school as well as for a band he had formed with his friends. Although the band didn't become a sensation, he did open for more popular bands before eventually disbanding. As he got older, Danhausen worked for a theatre for 5 years before shifting careers to being a nurse, which is very nice. Eventually, he realized a career in nursing wasn't what he had envisioned, and he went on to pursue a career in wrestling. One of his earliest wrestling influences was none other than fellow AEW wrestler Colt Cabana. Around the time he graduated from high school, he began listening to Colt's Art of Wrestling podcast, and this allowed him to gain insight about the inner workings of the business and how pro wrestling works, as well as the independent scene as a whole. Years later, he would meet Colt at a local wrestling event where he asked his opinion on starting a career as a wrestler, before Colt encouraged a young Danhausen to pursue his dreams. Before he became the Danhausen that we know today, he was a solid worker, having trained with the likes of Colt Cabana and Jay Lethal, and his early career saw him put on good matches against the likes of Ricochet and Johnny Gargano, showing off his strong foundations. Although he had worked on his in-ring skills, he lacked a character. Going by the name of Kid Gorgeous Donovan Danhausen, he felt like any other indie wrestler. He stated in interviews that at the time he stopped enjoying wrestling as he wasn't being himself and he didn't stand out. Once he adopted his new Danhausen persona, that's when he really started to have some fun. He stated he was frustrated with trying to please people and just wanted to be himself, so he embraced the wackiness of Danhausen and has grown creatively ever since. Or at least as he puts it, he was limited when he wore his human makeup and became successful after embracing his true evil. Before being very nice, very evil, Danhausen used to just be very evil. He published a short 1-minute film titled The Beginning of Danhausen in January 2018, where he was depicted as a classic Nosferatu-style character. Early versions of the Danhausen character were supposed to be more horror with almost no elements of comedy. He would wear face paint referencing different horror shows or local bands, while playing a very serious and ruthless character in the ring. The true birth of the very nice, very evil version came when he performed for an independent promotion called Old Wrestling, which is supposed to be set in the 1920s. His inspiration came from the horror film Shadow of the Vampire, where William Dafoe depicts a real vampire who is hired to play the role of an on-screen vampire who is explained away as being a method actor. He is also inspired by The Simpsons, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, as well as Tim Burton's Batman movies. On the wrestling side of things, Danhausen's obsession with horror dates back to when he saw Kane's WWF debut as a kid, a moment that got him into wrestling to begin with. Speaking of inspirations, Danhausen has also been described as Conan O'Brien if he was possessed by a demon. Unsurprisingly, Danhausen cites Conan as one of his inspirations for his comedy, and somebody that he has observed over the years. In 2021, at the request of his fans, Danhausen participated in a contest held by Conan himself, leading to him meeting with producers of his show. 2 days later, he was asked to appear on Conan's podcast, Conan O'Brien Needs a Friend, where he told him all about the character and how he had influenced him. An unexpected product of the podcast was Danhausen's own branded coffee, as after watching the episode, a small craft coffee producer called Rootless Coffee Company sent Danhausen a gift coffee pack and invited him to their facility. This led to the two partnering and creating Danhausen Coffeehausen, which sold out in a single day. Fanhausens will know that Danhausen has somewhat of an unhealthy obsession with teeth. He regularly carries a jar of teeth and has incorporated them into his gimmick. The teeth became a thing after Danhausen posted a picture of him pulling fellow wrestler Bobby Beverly's mouth and captioned it, "I want to eat my opponent's teeth." From there on, the teeth became a sensation and he started using them in his matches, putting them in opponents' mouths to disorient them and attack them. He said this allows him to avoid being disqualified as his opponents already have teeth in their mouth, so technically the move is legal, and that's very evil indeed. The teeth sensation got so big that pro wrestling celebrity David Arquette mailed Danhausen his own tooth. One of the ways Danhausen has made himself stand out is his dedication to his craft, with him consistently working in character not only in the ring but on his own YouTube channel. Danhausen runs his own vlog, but unlike most wrestlers, he stays in full gimmick at all times, face paint and all. Whether he's at wrestling conventions or just going to a fast food place, he is always in character while vlogging. This in turn has only helped grow his following, with his viewers warming to his unique personality. His YouTube channel has almost 100,000 subscribers and he posts regular content. Along with vlogs, he also does interviews titled Good Night Housen, and famous guests include Chris Jericho, Matt Hardy, and many more. His channel also includes skits and promos, as well as unboxing videos. And related to his unboxing videos, Danhausen is a huge action figure enthusiast and owns a large collection. As a comic book fan, most of his figures are Marvel related, and he stated that his favorite action figures include Spider-Man, most Spider-Man villains, as well as other Marvel characters such as Deadpool and Moon Knight. His love for superheroes isn't only limited to Marvel though, as he also owns a large Batman collection. He obviously also collects wrestling action figures, with some of his favorites being Kane, Mankind, and CM Punk, although he collects others too, a hobby shared by fellow wrestlers such as Matt Cardona, Brian Myers, and Ethan Page. Recently, Danhausen even launched his own action figure produced by Zombie Sailor. The Hasbro-inspired figure comes complete with a signature cape and a jar of teeth. Wrestling booker, manager, and podcast Jim Cornette, renowned for his criticism of comedy wrestlers and almost anything from modern wrestling, has surprisingly revealed himself to be a fan of Danhausen. Cornette has revealed that he likes how Danhausen applies logic to his character, although he's gone on to say that he doesn't want to see him wrestle just in case the magic is spoilt. Other big endorsements include The Rock, who Danhausen refers to as Rock the Dwayne Johnson, and calls him one of his favorite wrestlers and role model. The Rock has given Danhausen shoutouts on social media in the past. Other famous Fanhausens include Mick Foley, Bray Wyatt, and CM Punk. With a mission to conquer the world, Danhausen realized the best way to do this was to collect as much human money as possible, something he is well on his way to doing. His rise to fame has allowed him to have a lot of dedicated Fanhausens, which has led him to becoming a top merchandise seller. At the end of 2021, Pro Wrestling Tees revealed that Danhausen was the best-selling non-AEW wrestler on site, beating the likes of Mick Foley, Steve Austin, and Randy Savage. He was also sixth overall when taking into account AEW wrestlers, only topped by CM Punk, Kenny Omega, Orange Cassidy, Jon Moxley, and Brody Lee. Upon signing for AEW, he would become the fourth best-selling wrestler on ShopAEW.com when comparing the first 7 days of a talent being in the promotion. And finally, Pepsi Man, also known as CM Punk, played a role in getting Danhausen back into wrestling. After the Attitude Era died by the time he was in high school, Danhausen had no longer been interested in the product. As mentioned, he was more into music, being a drummer and being part of a band. However, as a fan of punk rock, it was CM Punk that brought him back in. Danhausen would continue to be a punk fan and would regularly watch WWE just to see him. Years later, after becoming a pro wrestler himself, he would become friends with Punk, with Pepsi Man appearing on his vlogs and the two engaging in friendly banter regularly on social media. Even Danhausen's finishing move, Good Night Housen, was influenced by CM Punk's own finisher, the Go to Sleep. Although if you ask the man himself, he'll insist that it was him who influenced CM Punk and not the other way round. And before you go, make sure you check out the truth behind the secret wrestling returns of CM Punk.